嗨，超凡遠距的朋友，大家好。这是一篇 summary 的作业啊、这个作业的成绩是中级三的第一课。那这一项作业是 summary， 所以我们要先了解什么叫做 summary。summary 就是摘要。那用英文来解释就是 a short, clear description that gives the main facts or ideas about an article or a work。也就是一个针对某文章或作品所表达的内容或想法所做短而清晰的描述。这一课的主题是 Not all hackers are the same， 并不是所有的骇客都是相同的。那到底有什么阻止呢？我这边列出四个项目。第一项就是 What do hackers do？ 第二项是 How do hackers work？ 第三项 Different kinds of hackers。第四项 How to protect ourselves from hackers， 用中文分别来描述的话，就是骇客都做些什么事情，骇客是如何运作的，有哪些种类的骇客呢，还有如何保护我们自己免于骇客的伤害。以下是进行摘要的时候可能会用到的单字。一 unauthorized 二 protocol 三 valid 四 manipulate 五 rush 六 passive 七 alter 八 verification 九 code。紧接着我们来看第一段，那原文我会快速念过，那在影片下方的连结、可以看到全文、可以慢慢去阅读。好，第一段 As computer use becomes more common, the need for security is more important than ever. One of the greatest security threats in the online world is computer hacking. Computer hacking is the unauthorized access to a computer or a network of computers.Hackers are people who illegally enter systems. They may alter or delete information, steal private information, or spread viruses that can damage or destroy files. But how exactly can a hacker get into a system to do these things? 以下就是针对这第一段、我所找出的一些重点，也就是第一段的摘要。进行这项训练的学员可以在一张纸上面、阅读之后写下你的摘要，就有点像是这第一段的大纲 outline 一样。那如果大家觉得直接输出英文没有很有把握的话，就可以先用中文来巩固自己的想法。那我现在针对我所列出的 outline， 我来用中文来巩固一下整个想法。本段的重点摘要是这样子：随着电脑越来越普及，安全层级也不断的受到重视。而为什么要有安全层级呢？因为骇客或者骇入电脑成为安全上最大的威胁。那骇入电脑事实上就是指未经过授权的侵入电脑，或者违法的侵入行为。那通常这些侵入的行为的目的就是要去改变、删除甚至窃取资讯，甚至也有散播病毒并且损害档案的一些骇客行为。用中文巩固好想法之后，就可以用英文来输出。那我们留到最后，再一次来进行整篇文章的 summary。紧接着我们来看第二段 ：Most hackers use information called protocols that are built into computer software. These protocols allow computers to interact with one another. Protocols are sort of like computer police officers. When a computer connects to another system, the protocols check to see if the access is valid. The protocols can also determine how much information can be shared between the two systems. Hackers can manipulate the protocols to get unlimited access to a computer system. 那紧接着我们一样来列出大纲、也先练习用中文把我们所做的大纲巩固好。那究竟骇客是怎么样进行骇入电脑的工作呢？通常就是利用刚才所说的协定，那协定就好像是电脑之间的警察一般，协定可以在两台电脑互相连接的时候允许电脑之间的互动，也 可以决定到底这两台电脑间要分享多少的资讯，而骇客就是利用或者操控这些协定。紧接着我们来看第三段。In fact, just the act of entering a computer network is considered hacking. This is commonly called passive hacking. Passive hackers get a rush from just being able to access a challenging system like a bank or military network. Another kind of hacker tries to do damage to a system. After hacking into systems,These hackers release viruses or alter, delete, or attack information known as active hackers. They are by far the more dangerous of the two. 紧接着我们再来看第三段的 summary, 我们一样先用中文巩固想法。骇客总共有两种，一种叫做被动型的，一种叫做主动型的。那被动型的骇客呢，光是侵入一个具有挑战性的电脑系统就感到很大的满足感，但是不竟然会进行破坏电脑、散播病毒、窃取电脑资讯的行为。而主动型的骇客则完全不同了，主动型的骇客会在侵入电脑之后释放病毒、改变资讯、删除资讯、窃取资讯，甚至破坏整个系统。紧接着我们来看第四段。The easiest way to protect a system is with a good password. Long and unusual passwords are harder for hackers to guess. For even greater security, some online services now use password plus systems. In this case, users first put in a password and then put in a second verification code that changes after the useraccesses the site. Users have to get the code via either email or special devices, such as a cell phone, that show them the new code to use to access the site. Even if a hacker steals the password, they won't have the code. Or if the hacker somehow gets the code, they still don't know the password.现在我们来进行这一段的摘要，先用中文巩固想法。究竟我们要怎么样保护我们自己免于骇客的伤害？首先也是最简单的，就是使用好的密码。那通常比较不容易猜测到的，比较长的，就是稍微比较好的密码。而现在通常我们也可以用加密的系统。那这种加强型的安全系统，事实上就是在进入这个网站之后，可以经由手机或者电子邮件信箱来取得另外一组的密码，我们通常称为验证码，然后再用验证码来进入整个系统。好，这样子我们就把整篇文章我们要输出的摘要都巩固好自己的想法了，我们就可以做全文的英文输出，这样子就完成了一项作业。As computers become more common, security also grows. Hacking is usually a big problem in security. So hacking is considered the biggest threat. What is hacking? Hacking is unauthorized access to a computer system, and it is usually done by illegal intruder. And hacking behavior usually alters,deletes or steals information stored in our computer, and sometimes hackers even spread viruses and damage our files. Then how exactly does a hacker do it? Usually a hacker makes use of protocols. Protocols are like police officers in our computer system. Protocols allow computers to interactWhen two computer systems are connected. Protocols also can decide how much information can be shared between two computers. And hackers manipulate and control protocols. And that is how hackers control our computers. Usually there are two kinds of hackers, so not all the hackers are the same. The first kind of hackers,is called passive hackers. Passive hackers feel a sense of satisfaction when they enter a challenging system, such as a bank, a military unit, or government organization. However, after they get that sense of satisfaction, they usually stop there instead of damaging the system. Active hackers are different. They enter the system, they release virus, alter, delete, steal information, and even damage the computer system. 现在我们来进行最后一段的英文摘要。How can we protect ourselves from hackers? It's pretty easy. We just need to have a good password. Good passwords are unusual passwords. They are longer and not easy to guess. And nowadays, we also use password plus system. The computer system using password plus system doesn't depend on only the password, but also a set of verification code that is sent to the user via smartphone or email that is under the control of the computer user.
加入超凡遠距，成就超凡英语缩写能力。